Hello students, in this video I will discuss exercise 11c where we have to calculate the area of a regular figures drawn on a graph paper. Basically this is not the graph paper, you can take it as a graph paper. What is the dimension of that graph paper? That is 1 centimeter squared paper or graph paper. So I hope you have gone through the previous video where I have discussed in details how you have to calculate the area of any regular or irregular figures drawn on graph paper or squared paper. I would like to discuss the 4 points which we have discussed earlier, because those are the important things. Without those points you cannot proceed with this exercise further. So quickly let us recapitulate those points. Those are: at first we have to start with counting of complete squares as 1. We have to start our counting by the total number of complete square that has to be represented as 1. Next we have to count the number of squares in which more than half of the square is included. That means more than half of the square is interior to the figure, not to the exterior. Next we have to count the half squares. And at last we can neglect the squares which is less than half. So with the quick recapitulation of those 4 points, I would like to start with question number 1. Basically all the questions I cannot discuss in the same video. Let us try to go through question number 1 and 2. Afterwards few consecutive videos will be available to you for that regular and irregular figures. So let us start our calculation for that question number 1. So here you can see the figure. This is a regular figure. Why it is a regular figure? As clearly you can see, this is a triangle. So as we have been instructed, we have to start our calculation by counting the complete square. So let us start our counting. 1, 2, 3. So here we are counting the complete square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. So total 28 complete squares are there in this triangle. So you should not write down like this because of that lack of space. I have just noted down the data for that complete square. You have to write down in details. I have discussed these things earlier also, and your presentation should be like this. You have to write down the complete sentence, that number of complete square enclosed by the figure, that is, instead of 23 it will be 28. So represent should be like this. Again and again I am telling, don't avoid this representation of that calculation is very much important. So we have completed the calculation of a complete square as the data is with us. That is, 28 complete squares are there in this regular figure. So next one is we have to find out the square which is more than half. So let us try to calculate the squares included by this triangle. More than half it is included, that means interior to the figure, not to the exterior. So I will represent that one with a simple dot. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 17 18 19 20 21 22 23 24 25 26 27 28 12 squares are there which are more than half. So more than half, that means we can count as 1, as you know that. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So third one is the we have to count the half square. If you are able to see that this one is not as half, this one is also the same. We cannot count this one as half. This one is obviously not half. This one is not obviously half. This one is less than half, less than half. This one is the definitely less than half. So according to this figure, we don't have any half square figure. And at last, as we have been told that we can neglect the squares which is less than half. Let me show you these are 1, 2, this 3, 4, these all of these are less than half, so directly we can neglect those. So we have to find out the summation of this complete square and more than half of that square. That means a total 28 plus 12, that is 40. And as I have told you earlier also, you have to mention the unit for that. What was the dimension of that square? The dimension of that squared paper was 1 centimeter. That means our unit is going to be in centimeter only, but as we have calculated the area, not the perimeter. So you should know how you have to represent the area and the perimeter. What should be the proper unit to represent area or the perimeter? As we are discussing about the area, it should be in that square form. Either you can write down 40 square centimeter or 40 cm square like this. So this was the basic thing. I hope this question number 1 is clear to you. So the area of the regular figure is 40 square centimeter or 40 centimeter square. Now in that same manner, let us calculate the area of our next figure, that is also triangle. So we have to start with complete square. So in that same format, I will use this kind of symbol to represent complete square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. 22 complete squares are there. Next one, we have to calculate the squares more than half, and that has to be counted as 1. So simple dot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 more than half squares are there, so it has to be counted as complete 1. That means 8 are there. Next, we have to count the half squares. Halves. So with precision we have to do our calculation. So this one, let me use the cross symbol to represent half. Cross, this is our half. Next, this one is our half. Next, is there any more which is half? Here we don't have any more. That means two we have. How you have to represent that? And this one complete, this one more than half, this one is half into half. So half into half, 1/2 into 2. Here you have to apply that cancellation. Here you have to do the cancellation. 2 is 2 divided by 2, that is 1. 1 into 1, that is 1. So in total it is going to be 22 plus 8, that is 30 and 1. 31 square centimeter, as it was the dimension. So why I have neglected this one? Because it is less than half. Clearly you can see this one is less than half. This one is again less than half. Definitely this one is less than half. This one is less than half. This one is less than half. Less than half. This one is also less than half. Is there any square which we have not included in our calculation? Sorry. No. According to me, we have calculated all the squares, and based on that calculation, our area of that regular figure is 31 square centimeter. I hope this is clear to you. That means I have tried to convey a message. That means how you have to calculate. Try to be attentive with your calculation, because it can lead to an error. So here I have tried to calculate with precision. If anything will be missing, that may be a part of the calculation, but you should be very much careful about it. So again, our next video will be on the topic of calculation of area of irregular figures. So try to go through, practice it at your home. Thank you.